doing my BoxyCharm unboxing, and this is going to be for the month of September. So I'm a little bit late on this. I did get this box probably about a week ago, but I haven't even opened it. And you guys probably won't notice because I'm pretty consistent about posting every like 4 or 5 days for my videos. But I actually haven't technically recorded in like a week and a half because I've just been so busy. So I'm excited that I'm back able to record again because it just feels so good to be able to talk to you guys on here. So we're gonna do September box. And let me just find something to open this with. Okay. All right, so let's get this open and see. I will say I've already kind of been spoiled on this, even though I hate when that happens, but I think with that was on the last one. Okay, I was gonna say with that Laura Lee thing that happened, but that was actually August box. So I haven't even been able to do a get ready with August box, so I'm probably gonna combine these two, and I don't even know, like I probably will do a quick get ready using the Laura Lee just so you guys can see bright eyeshadow colors. I know there's like a huge thing going on with her, but just in case you got it and you just wanna know what you can do with it, or if you haven't donated or whatever, at least I can show you some pops of colors and then maybe tell you a couple colors that I have from my cosmetic line that if you loved in there, I have something similar. So in this box, let me pull out the handy dandy. I love that they give this little pamphlet. That's like probably one of the best things when it comes to the boxes because I like to be able to tell, one, myself, I want to know what good of a deal I'm getting anyways. And then I also like to be able to tell you guys how much something would have cost had you bought it separate. So the first item in the box is, like I don't have enough eyeshadow palettes already, but it's I like Pretty Vulgar, so I'll take it. It's Pretty Vulgar, and it's their Nightingale Smoky Eyeshadow Palette, and it is normally a $35 palette, so this is what it looks like. Oh, and these are actually really nice colors, like, I just want to see what this color looks like. This is Clutch right here. So that's actually really pretty. It's not, I can tell that it's not super... super pigmented, but pigmented enough that I'll probably be able to get a really nice look out of it. Let me see. This is a matte. This is Swoop. Yeah, like that's actually a really nice matte. That has good pigment. So yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited for that. I don't think that is a bad eyeshadow palette to get. I feel this is kind of weird. It's all okay. That's better. Much better. Okay. Yeah, that was just all crimply. But yeah, I feel like that if you received this, you already got your money's worth. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There's 12 colors in here. So, and these are nice colors that are kind of, you can kind of use every day. Like you don't have to make a super dark smoky eye. You can do more of a brown smoky eye, which is kind of my everyday look anyways. Or you can go all out and get really dark with it. So I'll use this in my next get ready with me just so I can kind of show you guys. But this is not a bad deal. And if you like those kind of eyeshadow palettes, why not? Sometimes I feel like I might have a little bit of addiction with collecting stuff because I think about it and I'm like, I don't need all these eyeshadow palettes. I don't use all of them. Like, I usually use them like once or twice here and there, and then I like forget about them half the time until I am going through a declutter. And then I'm like, oh yeah, I have this. I should probably use it. Okay, so the next item is going to be Laura Geller, and it is a Baked Blush and Brighten. So I will say I've not used this before. This is normally $28, but I freaking hate those baked everything because I know everybody says scrape off the top and it works great, but I don't want to have to sit and scrape off the top of something. I just want it to work great. So I don't love these, but it's worth a try. The cool thing about this is because it's not like one color. It's like almost a blush highlighter in one. So it probably will look super pretty. Actually, that's not bad. I don't feel like you really have to scrape off the top of that. I might take back what I just said. We'll see what it looks like when I do my get ready with me because that's actually a really pretty color. You know what? Hold on. I just gotta know, guys. Just gotta know. Oh. I mean, I know I already have a little bit of something underneath, but it's like all day makeup. Wow, that's actually really pretty. Look how smooth that, well, I don't know if you can tell on camera, but like where I'm at, that looks really nice and smooth and not too harsh. Okay, I retract my previous statement because I did not have to scratch off the top of anything. So I'm happy with that. I would not, however, pay $28 on the regular for a blush, but I'm getting it in a BoxyCharm, so I can't complain. The next item in the BoxyCharm is the, and they're Alamar Cosmetics, and it's a brush set. So these are $18 for three brushes. And, I mean, honestly, I love getting brushes because I do the fake versus real. And now when I'm doing the fake versus real videos and I do the actual eye comparisons, like one eye fake and one eye real, I need so many different brushes so I'm not using the same one so I can really get a full look. So I feel like it's not the end of the world for me to get more brushes because I have to use so many. They're kind of a little flat, so I don't know if they just bent from the package. But this one will be a nice blending brush. I don't really know what that is. I don't know if it was supposed to be an angled brush or what, but probably you can use it for like an inner corner highlight or to highlight the top. This, however, I hate these brushes. I don't know what the hell to use this for. Like, I wouldn't use this on my eyebrow because it's not angled and it's just weird. Like, what do you use this for? Like, I like the small ones for under, I'll probably use it for under eye, but I won't like it when I'm using it. So these are like a waste for me. I'll find something to use it with them, but they are a waste. Oh, I can't throw them over here because I have to use them and then get ready with them. Okay, the next item is going to be, you don't say, a liquid lipstick. So this is by Lorac, the Pro Liquid Lipstick, and these are normally $19. Let me see here. This has gloss. This is a smooth glide of gloss. This is actually, this kind of looks like my color doing the most. Whole, that's funny. Look at how close that is. This is my color doing the most and this is theirs. So this is just a little bit darker and more, more purpley. Oh my God. I just knocked that. You can see my window. Ignore my window, guys. Okay. Much better. I already have selfie on right here, but I just want to see. It doesn't feel like super drying, so that's not a bad thing. I don't know how much I love this color with my makeup that I have on right now, because my makeup is super like warm tone, but it's a little sticky and it smells good though. It smells like a cupcake or vanilla or something, so I'm not mad at that. Okay, the last thing, and it feels very light, is the Butter London Stroke of Wow Roll-On Liner. Ooh, like an eyeliner? Oh my God, that's so weird. Have any of you guys used one of these? I've never used one before. It's like a little wheel. Oh, that's kind of scary. I don't know. You know what? I don't know if I would use it on my top liner, because I feel like it... I don't know, but maybe my bottom liner because it's so thin, but that's pretty cool. All right. Oh, it says shake me up. I probably should have shook it up. Yeah, because look, when you roll it, can you see how it kind of got like lighter or something there than it is there? Weird. I can't wait to actually try this. That should be interesting. So this is normally $19. We'll see if it's worth the $19, but all in all, I am not mad at this BoxyCharm because it came with a nice eyeshadow palette that I totally think is universal. That blush, I really actually like the blush, even though I said right beforehand I wouldn't like it. The brushes were just okay. I think one of those brushes would be a nice brush for me. And the liquid lipstick, I don't need any more liquid lipstick, but because of the this liner, which I don't know if I like yet, but it's cool to try it, and the palette and the blush, I mean, that's worth the amount of money BoxyCharm costs. So I'm happy with the box, and I hope you guys were happy with your box if you did order it. And if you haven't, and you can still get this box and you want what's in there, go ahead and order it. And then if not, I don't know what to tell you. Don't order BoxyCharm. Anyways, I will see you guys in the next video, and I'm going to be sure to try to do a get ready with me, and maybe I can kind of incorporate some of last month's BoxyCharm with this month's BoxyCharm, because I think a lot of it was different, except for, like I said, the eyeshadow palette. So maybe I can kind of incorporate them together. We'll see. All right, I will see you guys in the next video. Please give me a like and a thumbs up. And if you have not yet watched any of my fake first reels, go watch them and get me that watch time. Bye, guys.